Electronic dance music is created with machines that generate percussive and melodic patterns in order to make the listeners enter a state of euphoria.
Okay, let's introduce ourselves. Wait, should we introduce
everyone? Introduce yourself.
Yeah.
Why are we so?
My camera is.
Seems like we're in 2012 or something.
My camera isn't that. Sorry, Justin. Cool room. We got a cool room.
Thanks.
You made it worse.
Okay, so I guess I'll go first. I'm Mariana.
Oh, and I'm Adrian.
I'm Jocelyn.
Yeah. All right.
Who are you?
I'm Justin. All right, I'm gonna start off first. Why did you get into EDM?
Who? Oh, all of us?
Or yeah.
Just him.
We got a bed. My aunt, you know, Chantel. My aunt named Chantel, shout out to her. She used to go to all these raves when I was like a little, so I used to see her go, let's just say, like naked. Basically, it has to be like, oh, what's going on over there? And then I got questioned what it was. And then, so that's when I first got introduced to it. And then when I was 18, 19, I was like, I want to go to a rave. And then I went to a rave and it just, history changed my life, bro.
Okay. What was the first song that I heard or that you heard that made you like EDM?
The first song.
That's a good question.
Oh, DJ Blend. It wasn't even a song. He used to have YouTube videos. DJ Blind.
Okay.
Dude, classic. I was like 9 years old, going crazy in my room. DJ Blind is a DJ with the Chucky mask on. The OG's who he is, bro. That guy used to be popping.
What are your DJ inspirations and would you like to collaborate with anyone famous?
Patrick Toppin, hands down.
Okay.
He knows how to mix really good. I go on YouTube and I'll like watch him play on the decks.
Yeah.
And that's my biggest inspo. The way he like flows through a set. Cause you know, a set is like a movie. You know what I mean? You can't just play all over the place. You gotta go with like the same BPM, you know what I mean? So definitely Patrick Toppin. I probably would love to do a back to back.
What genres do you usually play at your gigs?
House, techno. Lately, I've been doing more techno. I surprise, like
house.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Let's see. That's 4, 5. How long have you been doing this, and when did you start?
DJ.
Yeah. So, this is a 2-part question. Sorry. How long have you been doing this, and when did you start? And where do you like to perform next in regards to venues?
Wait, so when did I start doing this? I started doing this probably like the end of 2021, or no, some 2021, beginning of 2022,
2022.
2022. Not that long, to be honest, because all my friends are DJs, so I didn't have to learn by myself. I had my friends that would actually teach me how to like properly know how to like DJ. Because when I first started, I thought I was doing good. Then when I hung out with my friend, I was doing everything terrible, 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 terrible. And then that helped me learn. So that got me to learn fast. And then I started making my own events. Wait, what was the other question?
And the second one was, where do you like to perform next?
Oh, probably like an Insomniac festival or a show like Academy or something. Definitely one
All
of those.
right.
Or any underground raves, to be honest. I love the underground scene.
Yeah.
They always pop off with big crowds.
What kind of music do you usually play? Mashups, singles,
Like on my phone?
or like mashups, or remixes, or any kind,
Like when he's DJing or what he's listening to?
like when you DJ, like do you play
Oh,
mashups? Do you play
okay.
singles?
I'll try to get vocals from another song or like vocals, and then I'll usually that I'll like have like a house song or a techno song that has no vocals, and then I'll add that vocal like a mashup basically, and I'll add that mashup into that and build it up with the definitely Matt. I don't like to mash up big songs, like probably like the un like low key things you never heard
Okay.
before.
Okay. Where do you get your songs?
Beatport, Beatport,
Beatport. Okay.
or SoundCloud. Like there's a
Yeah.
download option you can do on
Yeah.
SoundCloud. Yeah, but yeah, probably Beatport would probably be the best way, because if you don't get it from Beatport, then your music will be stripped, and then it'll mess up your USB and mess up the. So you always gotta buy it and be safe. Yeah.
Why do you love DJing?
Ooh. I don't know. Let's just say I was always the one connected to aux. So, like, I love to have ha see people have a good time. And I like, you know what I mean? Like the reaction. I like to get lit with them, because when I see them get lit, now I feel like I'm getting lit. So someone's happiness is my happiness.
All right. What equipment do you use?
Well, usually all I bring now is a USB and headphones, because usually all the equipment is provided for me, like CDJs 3000s, 2000s. Yeah, it's usually everything's provided for me now. I used to have to bring my controller and stuff like that and like do it myself, but there's once you get like in the, with all these underground scenes, everything's always supplied for you.
Right.
You just literally go in and plug in, and that's it.
What, speaking of which, what controller do you have?
Oh, I forgot the name of it, to be honest. I don't even know the name of it. It has four channels, but I still have to use a computer, which sucks. But yeah, I forgot the name of it, to be honest. Yeah, it's a big one. It's a nice.
All right. Last one. Any advice for aspiring DJs?
Oh, it's produce. You can't just be a DJ. Like, I think that's what I'm learning. I'm still learning too, you know what I mean? So I think you just have to start producing your own songs and use that song and post all your songs on social media. And if you have gigs, always record your gigs so you can use that as like a leverage to like get booked to other places, you know what I mean? Oh, here's my stuff, you know what I mean? Yeah.
Okay. That's it.
bless you.
Hello or aloha, my name is Justin Chu, and I'm a DJ and a potential DJ music producer. And my DJ stage name is Yukegini, and it basically means Justin, but in Hawaiian. And in case if people are wondering why is that my permanent DJ stage name or where I got it from, let's just say I got it from a good friend and brother of mine, Kyle Helgren, who went to Hawaii and got me a keychain that had both my English name and my Hawaiian name engraved in the keychain. And all this time, I've been thinking of a permanent DJ name and couldn't think of it until my friend Kyle got me this keychain, and it turns out the answer to my permanent DJ name was right in front of me all this time.
All right. Well, Justin, it is lovely to have you in this interview. My first question for you tonight is, Why did you get into EDM?
I got into EDM because I love the drop, and everyone's talking about how the drop is amazing, not to mention the bass is amazing as well. It's what they call a neargasm. Plus, when I hear an EDM song, it gives me the chills, like as if I'm there dancing at a nightclub or at a rave.
What was the first song that you've heard that made you like EDM?
My first song that made me like EDM was, in fact, Warp 1.9 by Stevie Aoki. Because funny story is that I heard this song for the first time in middle school when people were shuffling to it, and I didn't even know what they were doing and what was shuffling back then until I started shuffling when Party Rock Anthem by LMFAO came out. So the rest is history because now I know how to shuffle, and I'm a DJ and I love EDM. And it all started with him and his song.
Speaking of Stevie Aoki, what are some of your other DJ inspirations, and would you like to collaborate with anyone famous?
So Stevie Aoki, because he's Japanese, Florent Picasso, who happens to be Vietnamese, Jax Jones, Malaysian, Zoo, Chinese, Jonghyun, he's Korean, Afrojack, Martin Garrix, Marshmello, Slushy, who also happens to be autism, or who also happens to have autism, like me, Justin Prime, Justin Milo, Chami and Oliver Heldens, and any Future House, Future Bounce, Space House, Deep House, and Tropical House DJs and music producers. And part of the reason why is, I wanna, if any Asians can do it, I can do it too.
What genres do you like to play at your gigs?
Mainly Latin pop, Latin EDM, Halloween theme music, movie theme music, or movies played in, or songs that were played in the movies, like soundtracks, hip hop, top 40s, and all kinds of EDM, and the ones I've mentioned. Or like the ones I've mentioned.
Okay, my next question is, how long have you been doing this, and when did you start?
I've been doing this since high school, and just by using an iPad or tablet, so I started young, which I heard is a good thing. After my Ryohan Community College, I would like to perform maybe at a frat party next, like at any Cal State I go to, as well as weddings, bars, birthday parties, nightclubs like Exchange LA, the biggest, or at any raves.
What kind of music do you like to play? For example, mashups, sings, or remixes?
I mainly play mashups, but also play remixes and singles. So I would say 90% mashups and the other 10% for singles and remixes slash edits.
Where do you get your songs?
I get my songs mainly from YouTube and SoundCloud, and I download it via online video converter.
Why do you love DJing?
I love DJing because you get to have fun, play music you like playing for the crowd, see everyone dancing from the DJ's booth or DJ's POV, meet people, and I also heard that DJing is a chick magnet sort of thing because mostly all the young adults mostly like EDM, like it's this young generation of music. Plus, my friend Adrian, who is also a DJ, has a girlfriend.
Okay, my next two questions are for up-and-coming DJs or people who want to get into the scene. What kind of equipment do you use for your gigs?
As of now, I have a laptop, MacBook Pro, like the one I've been using, a MIDI controller called Akai, I believe that's how you say it, MPK mini professional controller to make my own music eventually. And a DJ controller mixer called Pioneer DDJ FLX4 two-channel DJ controller.
Any advice for aspiring DJs?
Have fun, be prepared to stand, know your music and crowd, feel free to dance, and don't be afraid to use your arms and hands for putting up in the air, like fist bump in the air, and as well as your feet and legs for jumping up and down.
All right, Justin, thank you so much for taking this interview once again, and we hope to see you soon.
Thank you.
Remember when we were young, breaking every rule they made. I never changed what we done. and made us who we are today. I'm taking every chance I get to make it so you won't forget who we are, who we are. Remember we used to run to the corner of 69. Yeah, they would come chasing us. We find a new place to hide out, making our plans to break out. Give me your hand and they will know who we are. Never be us.
Do you know who you messing with?